the entry document is the method used to present the project-based activity to the children. It can be in the form of a letter. It can be in the form of a video. And the letter always comes from an entity or a person that needs to have this done. With the video that we did for the oil spill, we showed different scenes from what's going on now. And then our principal, Ms. Whitworth, is at the end of the video, and she asked the kids, Decker Elementary, fourth graders, we need to know more about this. And so can you produce a newscast to present to the whole school to let them know what's going on? And so our principal has said we need to do this, so we're going to do it. So you always try and get something that's a bit dramatic so that they're drawn into it, and then that's their charge. When we start a project-based learning activity, we start with where are the gaps in your learning and what are we going to do in the project to fill those gaps. First, we're going to say everything that we know about this activity, and so that's just open-ended with the kids. What do you know? And they share, and I chart it down. Then we look at the list of what we know. We go back to our entry document. What is it that we're going to be producing? What do we need to know in order to have this end product? What is it we need to know? And so we take that needs to know, and that's where we base our research.
This is the list that all the needs to know that we need to research, that we need to do research on.
We're asking that for homework every night, they watch some type of newscast that gives coverage of the spill and its status.
It is shaping up to be the worst environmental disaster in decades. And
I got some fourth grade reactions on, you're going to have to watch the news every night. What if I can't find anything? I don't know where to look. So we gave them a list of the news stations to watch.
I found out that it was spilling over 200,000 gallons a day.
We want them to understand also the role of the media when something like a disaster happens. And so right now there are reporters investigating the Gulf oil spill. They're getting information from all angles using their needs to know. Once they've gathered the research, we're going to give them a lesson on how to do a newscast. And as part of that lesson, we're going to play like a local newscast. They're going to evaluate that newscast. What does a newscaster do? What's the mood? What's the tone? You know, how does that person present that? They're going to evaluate a newscast, and then from that, they're going to say, what are we going to do? And so at that point, they're going to determine the different roles that the team members, because each team, like I have five teams in my room, so each team is working on their own newscast, and so they will come up with their roles within that team. So they're going to decide who's going to be the anchor, who's going to be the reporter, who's going to be the producer, who's going to write the cue cards. And that's one of those things, like in project-based learning, the teacher has to ensure that she's got everything laid out so that you just keep feeding it to the kids. Okay, here's what you do next, here's what. So, and that's beginning with the end in mind, which is what the teacher has to do. So you have to lay out everything that's going to happen and then give it to the kids as they need it.
I am Paige Nate Payton. The oil came from the drilling company that exploded in the Gulf of Mexico. The oil started to leak in the ocean and then it started spreading and infecting animals. Almost about 3,000 animals died from the oil spill because the oil got on their feathers or fur. The kind of animals that died were fish, dolphins, turtles, whales, oysters, shrimp, and other kinds of shellfish.
El petróleo provenía de la empresa de perforación cuando explotó en el Golfo de México.
May 18, 2010, they said they can push cement down the well to stop the leak.
May 19, 2010, the oil spill made it to Louisiana and is now heading to Florida.
Now, Alexis, I have some questions about the oil spill. One of my questions is, how many gallons are coming out each day?
Well, Tavian, there's 210,000 gallons of oil coming out each day, which is a lot of oil.
Obama says the spill might be stopped for several days.
21 de abril 2010, 11 trabajadores murieron en la explosión.
Jordan, how many animals are dying in the
3,000.
Thank you, Jordan.
You're welcome.